follow the night. Spectacular! Spectacular! The words of the vernacular can describe this great event. You'll be dumb with wonderment. Returns are fixed at 10%. You must agree that's excellent. And on top of your feet, you'll be in all the
so exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting, it'll run for 50 years. So exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting, it'll run for 50 years.
Arabians,
Indians,
acrobats,
and duckling bears,
exotic girls,
fire beasts,
muscle and contortionists,
intrigue, danger, and romance,
electric lights, machinery,
and electricity.
So exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting, it'll run for 50 years. So exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting, it'll run for 50 years.
Spectacular, spectacular, no words in the vernacular can describe this great event. You'll be done with wonderment.
The hills are alive with the sound of music.
So exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting, it will last for 50 years. So exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting, it will last for 50 years.
Yes, but what happens in the end?
The courtesan and sitar man are pulled apart by an evil plan,
but in the end she hears his song,
and their love is just too strong.
It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside.
So exciting, the audience will stop and cheer. So delighting, it'll run for 50 years.
I'll play a secret song, I'll probably the evil one. Though the tyrant rants and rails, it is all to no avail.
Hey, the evil Maharaja! You are not escape!
No one could play him like you could.
No, I'm going to.
So exciting, we'll make them laugh, we'll make them cry. So delighting.
And in the end, should someone die?
So exciting, the audience is on the chair. So delighting, it will never be.
High School, is your band ready? Baldwin High School, you may take the field for a competition.
Thank you.
let's hear it one more time for Baldwin High School. First place with a score of 77.6. Baldwin High School.
Drum major, Eric Andes, and assistant drum major, David Jin. Is your band ready? Baldwin Highland, our marching band, will take the field in competition. Very good, I'm going to read this one. Thank you.
Are the judges ready? Drum Major, is your band ready? Presenting their 2007 program, Moulin Rouge, Baldwin High School, you may take the field for USSBA Group 6 Open Competition. Ladies and gentlemen, the Baldwin High School Marching Band from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, under the direction of Gary McKeever. And in Group 6, open competition with a score of 82.1. Winning the Caption Awards for Color Guard Percussion, Visual Music and Effect, Baldwin High School.
Presenting their 2007 program, Moulin Rouge, Baldwin High School. You may take the field for USSBA Group 6 Open Competition. Thank you.
welcome to the 2007-2008 Highlander Marching Band season. I'm Mark Despotakis, and we're here today to introduce you to a new web-only feature on the Highlander Band website. It's going to be called Notes from the Field. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to be giving you the stories of the major events of the 2007-2008 Highlander Marching Band season right here on the web.
And we begin this first Notes from the Field with a look at week one of band camp.
I love this show. I've always wanted to do a show that's like based off of a movie or a musical, and now we did. I love it.
This year's show is based on the 2001 movie musical Moulin Rouge. And this first week of band camp was the time to start putting that music and drill together. Sure, it's still a little rough, but look for the show to have some fast music, flags, and movement. And as always, some surprises. But of course, it takes a lot of practice and a lot of basics to get the show ready.
I'm actually pretty impressed with how basics and everything's going, and you know how far we've actually improved compared to last year. But yeah, so far I'd have to say it's going pretty good.
And we can certainly only hope and expect it to get better from here on out. And of course, make sure you stay with us on the website all season for more Notes from the Field. The end of band camp means the end of rehearsals in the humid weather. But it also means it's now time to start cleaning and perfecting the field show.
Compared to last year, I think we're starting off, you know, we're getting off to a really good start. Seems like individual marching's actually gotten a lot better. And, you know, people are not that they're necessarily taking it more seriously, but I think the show, people are more into it.
The guard gets to do a lot of neat stuff, especially with the hoops and the saber interaction, because we've never really done that before. So it's all really new.
What about the camp here?
Oh my gosh, that is like the funnest thing ever, except for whenever you like kick each other in the head, which is not good.
I think we're doing good, but we still have a long way to go, and the marching needs to improve a lot.
And one chance to improve that marching was at Kennywood, but only after spending some time enjoying the park.
The Bolden Band tends to bring rain with it.
And rain it did, but the band did get in a great and dry performance. You can now say the Highlander Marching Band season has officially begun. All of those summer practices have paid off, and the band is now adding to and perfecting the halftime show.
Well, I remember last year when we didn't even do any kind of show for some of the football games. This year, we had the whole show done by the end of band camp, which is really great. I mean,
one drummer talks about adding parts to enhance their part of the show.
The drummer, we're ahead of schedule. We've been adding new things, adding more instruments. Andrew Lord's been adding more stuff to the pit. We've been improving. We've been working our been marching more this year, so I believe we're pretty good.
So we're here at the very first away game of the year at the newly renovated Woodland Hills Wolves Arena. But we got to tell you, it didn't start off exactly perfectly tonight. There were a little bit of technical problems to getting the show on the field at halftime.
Some mechanical problems prevented one trailer from arriving at the football game. But thanks to the help of the band's logistics crew, other parents, and band members, the show got on the field.
I think it was responsible to the band. We didn't mess around. We understood there was a problem. Acted mature and worked hard on our part to make sure we got on the field out on time.
And after that, it was all about enjoying the Highlanders' victory over Woodland Hills.
And we just have a good time and enjoy each other's company, because with the way the school construction's going on, we don't see each other. And so right now, it's a really good time to see each other.
Next time on the Notes from the Field, we'll take you to South Fayette and Brentwood's band festivals. We'll see you next time.
I really like it this year. It's a really fun show. The Keller Guard has really improved over the past 4 years that I've been in it, and it's a lot of fun being a senior and having people, you know, understanding and listening how hard it is to be in the color guard.
It sure is a lot of work to be in the color guard, as well as the rest of the band. And even though the band is now into the season, there is still a lot of cleaning and perfecting to do.
I like all of it, but my favorite part would probably be, I call it the flying 32, because I'm like the shortest person and it's so hard to get to my spot. And for some reason, I love it, even though it's so hard to get to.
Now here's a rare glimpse for you. It's what the performers see as they're playing. We decided to place a camera on a snare drum. See more of Snare Cam, make sure to buy a season wrap-up DVD.
So after the performance at South Fayette this evening, we loaded the trailers, boarded the buses, and arrived right here at Brentwood for their festival.
And one of the surprises at the festival was a new trumpet soloist. It was a change made just hours before the show, due to an injury to the regular soloist.
When I found out whenever Scott came in crutches, he was up by Mr. McKeever was. And so he told us during the trumpet sectionals that we had to work on our drill, because I had to learn some of Scott's drill. I'm really relieved. I mean, it's just like a life experience, you know, and I hope to do it again in the next 2 years. I'll be staying up here.
Do solos again?
Yeah, do a couple more solos.
So what's next for the Highlander Band? Well, the competitive part of the season begins September 29th at Steel Valley, and you can be sure the Notes from the Field camera will be there to bring you all the stories. We'll see you next time. Notes from the Field is partnered with WTAE-TV's High School Playbook to include these webcasts on the High School Playbook website. WTAE's John Burton was at Baldwin for a pep rally, so we caught up with JB to talk about High School Playbook and WTAE-TV's high school sports coverage.
It's a great way to showcase everything that goes on with high school sports, not only just the games and the student athletes, but the cheerleaders, the bands, and we pick a band of the week, and we give them about 30 or 40 seconds on our Friday night highlight show to showcase what they have. And we know high school bands are some of the best bands in the country are right here in Western Pennsylvania, and we like to showcase them every week, and so they get a chance to get on TV and get some exposure.
So you can check out highschoolplaybook.com as well as the band's website, of course, to see the Notes from the Field.
Friday night's football game brought two notable events. First, the 8th grade band joined the high school band for the night. And one of the band's own was named the 2007 Baldwin High School Homecoming Queen, and she appreciates the support of her fellow Color Guard members.
It was nice to have them support me instead of just being on my own and having to walk. It gave me a little confidence boost, and I'm glad that I had them behind me.
Now, as exciting as all of those events were, the big news was Saturday night's competition at Steel Valley. Scoring a 77.6 was a great first show.
Our first actual show, I think we did really good. I think our individual marching was really good. We sounded really great musically. I think today's just, starting ground for a lot more. I think we're going to improve a lot more.
We're all working really hard and trying to get the beats up and up to par where they're supposed to be, and the season's doing real good because we're actually showing our talents and what we actually have from last year.
And we're back at the school. The uniforms are packed up. Everyone has gone home for the night. What happens next for the band? Well, next weekend is an off weekend. We use that as a chance to clean and work on the show a little bit more. And then it is our home competition right here on October 13th. And where can you see that? Here on the Notes from the Field. We'll see you next time. The entire Baldwin band and color guard were pumped up for the USSBA Central Pennsylvania Regional in Hershey on October 20th. Performing in Hershey means performing in a bigger stadium, but it also means a four-hour bus ride.
Four-hour drive out? I think that's fun, actually. The ride on the bus right here, sitting next to my friends, having a nice chat, watching movies the entire way up here. It's more fun than it is boring. I mean, bus rides are like the best part.
Well, we did this 2 years ago for the USSBA. We did well there too. There's a couple of mistakes, but I think it'll turn out to be the same way. We always do a couple of these long trips, and we always do well. It'll be fun.
Of course, a long trip means a stop for dinner at the Old Country Buffet before showtime. And from dinner, we busted up, came right here to Hershey Stadium. We've just arrived. Let me show you what's going on here, kind of behind the scenes. The band and the color guard are getting their uniforms right now. They're going to change. We're going to do a warm-up and hopefully have a great performance. But before we talk about that performance, here's a peek at the hard work that happens in the parking lot as the band warms up. Show is in the shadow of Hershey Park. And you know, trips like these create some great memories. About coming out here to Hershey and perform.
It's the most memorable trip ever. It has so many memories of this trip with injuries and everything else. It's intense.
Now the season is almost over, and there's one final show. It's off to Annapolis, Maryland for the USSBA Marine Corps Invitational on November 3rd.
And we will, of course, bring you a full wrap-up from that show here on this show, The Notes from the Field. Yes, with one final crescendo and one final splash of color, the Highlander Marching Band finished their 2007 season. Now the day started off early on Saturday with one final morning rehearsal before boarding the buses and heading to Annapolis, Maryland. Upon arrival at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium, the band had dinner in the parking lot, unpacked the trailers, changed into their uniforms, and got ready for what turned out to be their most impressive performance of the year.
This year is really, really good. We have a lot of potential. Some of these bands just come in one show and do it, but I think we can actually put up a fight this year compared to previous years. So. Pretty excited, really.
It's sad, but at the same time, it's exciting. I'm kind of ready to be done. This season's been really great, and over the years, I've had a great experience with the band. I've gone through a lot of fun things. We went on great trips, Bahamas being my favorite. But I'm really excited for the season to be over and really come out with something great.
Now, there's one student who's had an entirely different perspective all year. A view from the podium, and that's the drum major.
It's been challenging because, I mean, this show especially has been a lot of tempo changes and everything else. I mean, it's not an easy show, and I certainly had fun just being able to go up and conduct, and I really enjoyed the experience.
So after all the hours of hard work that began back in June, it came down to just 10 minutes on the field. And what a 10 minutes it was. It was good enough to score a 90.9. And that meant fourth place out of 31 bands in the show.
And that brings an end to the show. As you see, the band is behind me exiting Navy Marine Corps Stadium here in Annapolis, Maryland. It brings an end to the show. It also brings an end to the marching band season. But guess what? It does not bring an end to the Notes from the Field. We will be with you from Florida with some special editions from there. Make sure you join us then. And there will be one more wrap-up edition of the Notes from the Field coming up in a few weeks. A whole wrap-up of this entire season. We'll see you then. Practice of the season. We're actually right now starting our very last run through of the season. So we thought on today's Notes from the Field, we would take a look back at the entire season.
And there's probably no better way to look back at the season than to hear from the band members themselves. So here's a look and a listen back to their comments from throughout the season.
I think this show in particular is one that has to have a lot of energy, and I think the band does a pretty good job of pulling energy into the show. There's people pretty much sprinting across the field. It's really neat.
I really like the show this year. I think we've done a lot with it. I really like that we got to use the diamond rings, which was a really great prop for this year. I just overall really like the show, and I think musically it went really well, and it's really grown since the beginning of the season.
I'm actually pretty impressed with how basics and everything's going, and you know how far we've actually improved compared to last year. But yeah, so far I'd have to say it's gone pretty good.
I really like the show this year. I think it's tough, it's challenging, but yet it's rewarding. It's got good music. I mean, the harmonies, the parts,
different.
Yeah,
I love the show. There's so much more like running and like more like sets, more body moves, and it's like more visual effects.
It's a really fun show. The Keller Guard has really improved over the past 4 years that I've been in it, and it's a lot of fun being a senior.
I love the show. I've always wanted to do a show that's like based off of a movie or a musical, and now we did. So I love it.
Yep.
I never actually saw the movie, so I was thinking, I'm not going to know any of it, but it covers everything. You have, the excitement, you have the emotions and everything, and it's going to be a great season.
There were times where we like hit some walls, and I didn't know how good we would do, but I think we gave Diane our attention, and we really improved and did a lot better.
Being a senior, so far, it just doesn't really seem like I'm a senior. Like the whole senior rec thing, this was a blur, really, more than anything else. I mean, I felt like I was a junior, and I shouldn't be watching the other people go.
I really like the show this year, and I think once it's all done and we get like all the band's body movements and the guard finishes the show, that it's going to be really good.
I think we're doing good, but we still have a long way to go, and the marching needs to improve a lot.
We're trying to put more pizzazz into it, like on the can-can, whenever the whole band moves around. We have to try to inform on that while also playing our parts good.
The season in general, I think it's a lot of fun. It's intense. It's hot in every single way, every single aspect. I think we're okay. We could be a little bit better, but I think we're good.
I think the show is a lot tougher this year. I think we're handling it really well.
The show this year is doing pretty good. It's been better than some years. It's very upbeat. We're playing it well. We're on the schedule. So I think it's pretty good.
The show was going along exceptionally well. I mean, it's a lot better than I thought it definitely would go, because we got a bunch of freshmen. I wasn't sure of how soon they'd pick it up, but everything seems to be going okay. I mean, the music sounds great, the drill's great, just everything is just pulling together, so it's pretty good.
The guard gets to do a lot of neat stuff, especially with the hoops and the saber interaction,
The show's definitely shaped up, and it looks really great.
This is pretty much as good as it gets.
Of course, what's a trip to Walt Disney World without a ride on Space Mountain? Welcome to this special Notes from the Field Florida edition, with a recap of the 2008 Highlander Band trip to Orlando, Florida. We begin our trip retrospective with a look at the band's march down Main Street, USA, in the Magic Kingdom.
saw Manchu was really cool. There were so many people all lined up just to see us perform. It was really hot though, because we were really warm, but it was interesting.
It was an experience. It wasn't like New York, but it was so fun. It was hot, but I can't complain because I didn't have sleeves on my uniform like the band did.
Of course, the performances didn't end with the marching band. The stage band and symphonic band also made appearances on the Magic Kingdom stage.
School Symphonic Band from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
It was hot, but it was definitely like worth it. I mean, Symphonic Band was amazing. That was like probably our best performance we've ever done so far. So, marching band, it was short. It was shorter. It felt like shorter than Kennywood, but it was definitely a great experience.
And you can see more of these performances on the Highlander Band season DVD.
After all the hard work by the symphonic band, the stage band, and the marching band, it's time to have some fun on the trip. And so here we are today, the entire day in Disney's Hollywood Studios with some great rides like Rock and Roller Coaster, Indiana Jones, The Stunt Show, and the Tower of Terror.
I like MGM because I like the Rock and Roller Coaster, and I like Gun Fest.
I'm really proud of myself because I went on Dinosaur, because I'm terrified of dinosaurs. That was amazing. I really like the Tower of Terror today. Okay. I like this part the best so far, I think, MGM.
So obviously we know to expect great rides and great experiences at Walt Disney World. But let's get to the real heart of things. What about the food?
There's been like the race here about who can get the most out of their meal coupons and everything. And so, you know, there's all this wonderful food at Disney. So what's your take on what you've been eating, what you got, what's your favorite thing to eat, anything like that?
I've had chicken fingers like almost every single night. The food here is really good, but they have like the same food in all the different stands. They have ice cream bars shaped like you said, and those are pretty good.
And you like those?
Yeah.
There are obviously so many more memories we couldn't fit into this short few minutes, but we hope we gave you a sense of the wonderful performances and great times our Highlander Band members had in Orlando. Until the next Notes from the Field in August, I'm Marcus.
Thank you.
Grand High School Stage Band from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of your day here in the Magic Kingdom.
Thank you.
School Symphonic Band from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of your day here in the Magic Kingdom.